Wow, welcome to the week of comic book news.
Yeah, apparently when everyone's talking about Marvel Civil War rumors, DC's over there going, hey, we're still...
All right, just throw everything at him. Here it is.
DC has given us their movie lineup, their movie cinematic scope and plan up through the year 2020. Kicking it off in March 2016, we have Batman v Superman Dawn of Justice. At this point, you know what I think about that. Really, my arguments have all started to dissipate because my main argument was that's not a Man of Steel movie. It's a Justice League Beginnings movie. And that's now what they're calling it. And that's how they're treating it. And Batman and Superman are going to have their own standalone movie. So I'm like, oh, all right. That is what that is. So there you go. I'm starting to go over to Team Batflick's side also. Jesse Eisenberg. Still don't see it. Point is, I am looking forward to the movie, and I give DC credit. They're very self-aware. They know that Marvel has cornered an entire market of comic book movie fans. They're kind of late to the game on this, and when you're new, you can't be a level 1 in an MMO and go fight a level 20. It doesn't work that way. So Batman v Superman's coming out in March, so it can rule the cinema up until the summer movie season. However, that August, we get a Suicide Squad movie, which I feel like that's more of a gamble. You would think that Suicide Squad would have come out in March, and Batman v Superman would have been August. I think what they're doing is they're like, alright, Batman v Superman, God willing, everyone loves it, then Suicide Squad will just sell on the name alone. The fact that it's part of that universe. Thinking! But still risky. Suicide Squad's interesting to me because it's an ensemble of people and I don't know what ensemble they're gonna have. They're gonna have Harley Quinn, Deadshot, who's gonna play him? Who knows? In June 2017, we have a standalone Wonder Woman movie with Gal Gadot. Yes, Gal Gadot. In one of my videos about her, I called her Gal Gadot. Someone was like, oh, actually, it's pronounced Gal Gadot. So in the next one, I said Gal Gadot. People were like, oh, actually, it's pronounced Gal Gadot. And I was like, what is it? So I looked it up and I saw her pronounce her own name. And she said Gal Gadot. There is a T there, so it is officially Gal Gadot. Thank you, actually people, for getting me to doubt myself for no reason whatsoever. But a standalone Wonder Woman movie. It's gonna be the New 52 Wonder Woman that irritates some people. For me, it's fine because I read the New 52 Wonder Woman. But I said in one of my other videos that a standalone Wonder Woman movie would be awesome because it'd be like Terminator 2 meets Thor meets God of War. I was talking about New 52. But with this news now, I do feel like Wonder Woman being in Batman v Superman is just gonna kind of be a cameo. It's like, oh hey, I exist. On to my movie. Still don't know how she's gonna do as an actress. I'm really skeptical about that aspect of it. I would really be irritated if I watched it and I was like, well, that's all just wasted. November 2017, Justice League Part 1. Justice League is gonna get its own movie now. Which is interesting because not all of the Justice League people will have been introduced by now. You still have Aquaman, Green Lantern, Flash. All these people have not had their standalone movie yet. I don't even know that they've been in Batman v Superman. If they're in Batman v Superman, are they gonna be in the other ones from then until the Justice League movie? Point is, now you get a Justice League movie, which might just be the introduction to a few more characters. In March 2018, The Flash. Okay. I've seen the first two episodes of The Flash. I don't know if I should do it. Do you want me to do a video on that? I don't know. Like, I did Gotham. But point is, I like the dude from the TV show. He's really likable. He's a good Barry Allen. He's a good Flash. I'm on board. I feel like with the movie, I'm gonna compare him to the other dude, and it's not fair. And you do have the thing in your mind, like, well, if they're making a Flash movie and a Flash TV show at the same time, will one make the other one irrelevant? DC has said that the cinematic world and the TV world are not linked. They're not related at all. And you can argue that they made Superman Returns while Smallville was still going on. Granted, not a lot of people like Superman Returns, but it's happened before. That's my point. July 2018. Aquaman with Jason Momoa. Holy shit. When I heard Jason Momoa was gonna play a DC comic book character, I was like, yeah, Lobo. That's who he's gonna be. He's gonna be Lobo. No, he's gonna be Aquaman. Oh my God. I read the Jeff Johns Aquaman arc, and I still profess, if you think Aquaman's a piece of shit and you think he's dumb, read the Jeff Johns Aquaman arc. Throne of Atlantis in particular. He's a really cool character. He's a badass, actually. But I feel like this Aquaman is gonna be way hardcore. I feel like he's gonna be Aquaman, but he's gonna look like the forever evil Sea King Aquaman. I feel like they're trying to detach from, the pretty Aquaman, the Aquaman that people generally speaking don't like, although the Jeff Johns Aquaman was drawn that way. They gotta pitch Aquaman to people as being a badass and different just by the look of him. So they got Jason Momoa to do it. So all right, fair enough. We'll see how it goes, but dude, poured a pot of melted gold on a guy's head, for God's sake. That's what happens when you pollute his oceans. April 2019, Shazam! You've already kind of heard my take on this because I did a video about The Rock being Black Adam in Shazam. The Rock's Black Adam. I would have preferred him to be Shazam because he's so damn likable, but he's gonna be a badass bad guy. I hope they get a really likable guy to be Shazam and a likable kid to be Billy Batson. It's one of the standalone DC movies I have the most hope for. I think Shazam's cool. No one's done a movie for him, so do a movie for him. And now they're doing it. Then June 2019, Justice League Part 2, which at least at this point we've had the introduction to all the DC characters before, so there that is. Now they can all be in a movie together. I really can't say anything about a part two that I didn't already say about a part one. Holy shit, never mind. There are two characters that did not have their standalone movie that they're getting their standalone movie now after the second Justice League movie. First of which is Cyborg. Cyborg, for me, has always been a really good Justice League character, but has always been introduced as a Justice League character. It's always been a part of the Justice League. I haven't actually seen a standalone Cyborg. I mean, I'm not saying it can't work. Obviously, it can. As long as you have a dude and a problem and he's a cyborg, you'll have a movie. Batman v Superman. Supposedly, this dude is in that movie, and now he gets a standalone movie at the end of everything. Also skeptical about the guy they have to play him. I don't really have an opinion on the matter because I know nothing the guy's been in, because you look at his IMDb page, he's been in two things, one of which is Batman v Superman. That's right, 50% of his filmography is not even out yet. I can't tell you what this dude's done. I can't tell you if he's a good actor. So I think Cyborg's cool in the Justice League comics, but again, as part of an ensemble. Standalone, we'll see what happens. And now it dawns on me. Through all of this, Batman v Superman, Justice League Part 1, Justice League 2, and all the movies in between, we have not had a Green Lantern standalone movie yet. It has not had its mulligan. And now at the end, the very end of this announcement, we finally get it. Does this mean that Green Lantern is not in any of these movies? He's not part of the Justice League until now? Or are we gonna see him be part of the Justice League and now we're going to get his story and now he's gonna fight Sinestro and all that shit? No idea. Again, all speculative. All I've heard is that these movies are coming out. No one gave me anything with it. Not like DC was like, Jeremy, all right, between you and me, here's what we're doing with Green Lantern, just because it's you. I'm not that special. I just am not. But I am excited to see Green Lantern get a second chance. Here's what I think they should do with that. Have Hal Jordan be brought on as a Green Lantern. Immediately be like, oh yeah, there was this other guy. He was a good Green Lantern. His name's Sinestro, and now he's going against us, so you gotta take him out. Like, and immediately make Sinestro the bad guy. Because no one wants to see a big cloud come after Earth and Dr. Bighead. No one cares about that. Give us Sinestro right off the bat, and I think we'll be fine. Alright, so that's the announcement. That's the news. That's what DC has given us after everyone was talking about Marvel Civil War. Come on, escalation says now Marvel needs to announce that Civil War is actually happening. So all these movies, all these announcements, all this information, what do you think about it? What movie are you looking forward to the most? Whatever you think, comment below, let me know. And as always, if you like what you've seen here and you want to see more, click right here to see more.